Hey, what's up, you guys? So everyone knows about how I'm all about how life happens in the moments in between. So I came out here to this hardware store to pick up a parcel that was sent to me by my buddy Patrick. So this is my New York Comic Con loot, so I'm super excited. So my dad was able to get someone who was coming up and down here, and they left this parcel with some guys that they know who own this hardware store. And I was like, oh my god, why would you do that, you know? But you know what, I got it. So I'm gonna head on back to my office and we're gonna unbox this, well, unpackage this thing, I guess. So super excited to see what's in there. So chat to you guys in a bit. Alrighty then, so I have returned to my office at last. Crazy day, crazy day. So in anticipation of this, I am now donning my white gloves. This is a little in-joke. So I belong to a group of collectors, and every time anyone has a really big item come in, or a really special item or something they've really been anticipating, you don your gloves, you know? So yeah, so I'm very blessed and very, very fortunate to have a friend named Patrick. He recently attended New York Comic Con, and he scored some goodies for me. So I don't know what's in the package, you know. There were some, you know, pictures that he showed me of stuff that he was thinking of getting me, but whoa, okay, right. Things are already looking like crazy over here, right? But on the whole, I'm not really sure. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to take everything out of the bag. I'm going to reach into the bag and pull stuff out. And as I pull it out, I will tell you about it, right? So let's see. The first thing we have is, of course, yes, the Comic Con Africa visitor guide, right? So, yes, Comic Con Africa, such fond memories, right? Great stuff, good stuff. Okay, so let's reach into the bag again. And let's take out something else. Is it this thing? Right? Oh, my fucking word. Okay, right. So, it is the New York Comic Con, right? The New York Comic Con visitor's guide, right? So the visitor guides are essentially like another collectible in and of itself, right? And it has the Batman Damned artwork by Azzarello. So it's by Lee Bermejo. So and written by Azzarello. So yeah, that's been awesome. I really wish I had been able to attend New York Comic Con, but next year I'm gonna be there with you guys, right? I'm gonna be there with you guys. So let's see, right? Something else. What do we have here? Okay, so this is the Wonder Woman blank. Okay, it's called Wonder Woman blank, right? So this is a promo that was run where you essentially have a completely blank comic, right? And what happens in there is that you can, you know, get commissions, or you can get artists to pop stuff in over there. So this is excellent. Now, Wonder Woman is one of my favorite characters. So okay, so I got ideas coming out of here now where I would love to get some guys to do commissions for me. So okay, so that's awesome. Okay, let's see what else is in here. Okay, so let's see. I love diggers, right? So let's see. okay. Wait, I can't see, right? I can't see. Okay, so I tear up very, very quickly. It's because of allergies. Not because I'm super emotional, but okay. Cool. Right. Okay, right. So I've got Detective Comics 987. It's the Mark Brooks variant, right? Yes, man. Okay, also this is super tops. This is going in my display like right now, right? Okay, well, not right now, but as soon as I get home, right? So yes, man. Okay, that's awesome. Okay. So let's see what else is in there, right? Let's see the feel over here. I'm trying to be honest about it, not like look into the actual packet and put something out. So let's see. Okay. Dark Knight's Metal 1, right? Signed by Scott Snyder. Oh, what? Okay. Signed by. Okay. I'm okay. Okay. So it's signed by Scott Snyder and the it's coming. Okay. Okay, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. Okay. Oh my God. Now, I'm a massive Batman fan, right? I'm such a massive Batman fan, and like to have this stuff over here. Okay. Okay, let's see what else is here. Let's see what else is here. Let's see. Okay, I see. Okay, I see we've got a print over here. Okay. Okay, so Tim Sale, right? Tim Sale is, oh my God, Tim Sale. Okay, so Tim Sale is one of my favorite artists, right? So I've been following his work for years and years. Some of you may not may rec let's try that again, right? Some of you might recognize the name. He did artwork for Heroes, right? So he did artwork for Heroes, and there was a TV series, right? So yeah, I love so okay. Let's try that again, right? So Tim Sale, he did artwork for Heroes, right? Heroes was a series with Hiro Nakamura, and so there was a guy on the series who had the power of seeing the future, and he would draw it or he'd paint it. And Tim Sale was an artist who did this, right? So I collect, like, I have so much of Tim Sale's work, and now I actually have like a side. I'm so happy. Okay, so this is going in my display. This is going in my display. I need to figure out a way and how to put this in my display. I'm so excited. Okay, this is awesome. Oh, this is awesome. This is awesome. It's right with my birthday, right? So, okay, so let's see what else. Let's see what else is in here. Okay, let's see what else is in here, right? Okay, so there's a little bit. Okay, thanks. Okay, so badges, right? Oh wow, oh yes. Okay, so I collect badges, right? And this is the DC badge, right? So that will go on to my display case. And we have a Luke Cage. Okay, I see what he means, right? So yeah, this is the Luke Cage Pop Mini. It's a keychain, right? And I think Patrick is trying to say that this looks like me. So yeah, I'll take it. I'll take it. I'll take it. We've got a Harley Quinn pin. Lovely pins over there for my collection. And then he actually gave it to me. Okay. Goosebumps, right? Goosebumps, goosebumps, right? Okay. So, oh, a fucking word. Okay. So let me tell you, right? We all have our favorite artists, we all have our favorite creators, and I have so many of them. I mean, there's in no particular order, there's Todd McFarlane, Brian Michael Bendis, Alex Maleev, Tim Sale, Lee Bermejo, there's so many of them, right? So like I'll be here, Mark Bagley, there's just so many guys who I follow their work, and I get really excited about it, and it's this is my thing, but there's one guy who is definitely he stands head and shoulders above them all, right? So I got back into comics in 2000 and like 8 2000, 2000 yeah 2009, right? A friend of mine, Nelly Tao, bought me for my birthday. She bought me a copy a graphic novel of Hush, right? So I think you can guess where I'm going with this. And Hush is probably one of my favorite comic stories, and Jim Lee is my favorite artist. And Patrick told me he met Jim Lee, and he told me that Jim Lee gave him the Sharpie that he was using at the con. I got Jim Lee's Sharpie. I can't. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. I'm like this thing over here. I'm just looking at it. And I'm like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Okay, so I'm sorry that was disgusting. I can't do this. I can't do this. I'll talk to you guys just now. Okay, so I'm calm now. More or less. I never understood it before. You know, you hear about people like losing themselves and going all kinds of crazy and this and that. And like for me, I'm gonna get real with you right now. I was a little bit of a weirdo growing up. You know, I think most of us are were. Choose the appropriate tense. And I really found like a sense of belonging. With these hobbies, with the stuff, with my hobby, with the stuff. I'm normally a lot more articulate, but like this stuff, it represents a certain part of me, and I think most of us. Like when I was growing up, one of the earliest memories I have of when I was in school was I had this lunchbox, right? It was one of those big ass ones that has the juice bottle and stuff in it. And I wear hear well, I have a hearing problem, so I used to wear hearing aids. So a lot of the time when people are talking to me, I can't really hear what they say. So I lip read, and I'm just trying to be very open and honest about stuff right now, just to try and make you understand like how moved I am by this stuff, And basically, like I remember, I was sitting on the bank, or on my school grounds. I didn't have any friends because I was this weird kid, like really awkward, this big ass hearing aids was just not fun at all, And now I found like a sense of belonging, a sense of identity and value, in comic books, in action figures, in this hobby, And now years later. To have connected with so many different people on so many different levels because of this, my life is so much more brighter for it. I'm so blessed, really. And to Patrick, my brother, dude, thanks a lot, my man. Thank you so much. I owe you, bro. I owe you. So, yeah, I'm gonna go now. I'm going to compose myself. I'm going to look through this footage. To decide whether it should be just at the raw emotion and really embarrass myself like that, or I don't know, I'll have to decide. Yeah, I'm just so happy right now. So, yeah, I'll chat to you guys soon. Bye.